lecture is devoted to the optimal control. And first of all, I'm going to show that actually optimal control is again about attainable sets. So now our setting, we have as usual a control system. Belongs to you. And I assume now that I need some continuity. So I assume that this guy is continuous with respect to uq, is smooth with respect to q when u is fixed as continuous with respect to u, okay? And u is now subset of in another manifold, and it is uq, f uq is continuous, is well defined as continuous on the closure. Actually, basic result, basic result which I'm going to explain during the lecture of optimal control theory is Bondragian maximal principle, and it is valid for any u. That's strange, but it's valid for any u. But it's for any set u. If it is, we assume that it is continuous on the closure of u multiplied by m, and then any u is available. But other results, in particular existence of optimal control, needs more properties, valid only for more specific sets, and this I fixed. But first, let me explain that optimal control. So assume that we already know, during previous lectures, we studied the problem to get Q1 from Q0. Alone, and one more remark. Now, since I would like to find something optimal, then my space of control function should be closed in a certain sense. Because if I would like, how you try to find something optimal? If you already know that you can go Q1 from Q0, you try to do it better and use some minimizing sequence, and you wish this minimizing sequence to converge somewhere, so your set of admissible functions cannot be piecewise constant, because when you take sequence, it could be more and more pieces, and at the limit, you lose the limit. So you need some complete spaces somehow. And in this setting, it is convenient to use control function. The space of control functions is u of dot, say, that sent. This is L infinite functions, t into u of t. It's L infinite, so measurable bounded, okay? On the segment where it is defined, or it can be defined on the whole semi-line, t is always positive or negative for us. So it's measurable bound, L finite. Okay, so that is our setting now, but since we are going to discuss about optimal control, then we need something to optimize. We consider a cost, some functional, that call it, say, g with a parameter t that we would like to minimize. It is going to be just integral functional. So it's a kind of generalization of classical calculus of variation. T of phi of q of tau photon. Okay. And we try to minimize this function among all trajectories of our system. So it depends both on the state of the trajectory and on control. In most simple unconstrained variational problem, classical variational problem, when we do not have non-trivial dynamics and all trajectories are available, then we have just fu equals u, and u is just velocity. And here we have q dot, okay? Particular case when q dot equals u, and we have a cost that depends on the, we have admissible curves, they are velocities, control is velocities in these cases. And cost depend on q, q dot. It is way in which it is generalizes optimal, generalizes classical variational problem. Okay? So we minimize this guy among all trajectories which connect q0 with q1. All trajectories with connect. So we need at least one to have a chance to find the minimum. And let me now explain that the time t, when we minimize, there are two versions of this problem. One fixed time t, we would like to get q1 exactly in time t1. Or we do not care in which time we do it. So there's just two versions free time is, by the way, simply can be reduced to constant time, and in general, we can formulate many different versions of optimal control problem. We can take another cost, we can fix moving endpoints, assume that endpoints belong to some submanifold here, belong to some submanifold, or just trajectory is periodic, things like that. All these problems, since the setting is very general, we have arbitrary dynamics, all these problems are more or less can be reduced one to another up to some details. And fixed time, free time, and of course, always there are some details. It's not completely totally equivalent, but the method of studying is the same, and reduction, this reformulation works well. And in general, actually, if you would like to see the nature of this problem, as I would like to explain right now, that it is about attainable set. Look, so for me, it is too, we have here too many symbols. We have dynamics, we have Lagrangian the function, and I would like to unify. So first, now I explain you why one way to reduce one problem to another. I would like to look at it more geometrically and not to use too many symbols. I would like to consider it's not a problem to consider phi, this cost as a incorporated in dynamics. So what we do, let us consider extend system. We can extend the system in the following way. We consider first of all, instead of m, we consider the m that is r multiplied by m. I would like to treat cost as one more coordinate on the dynamics. That's the idea. Since it is integral, it's defined for all t, and then I take f u of q is a phi of q u f u of q, okay? And write a system and say q bar here is, and write the system, and, oh, x, let me call x belong to M U, the set of controls is the same as before, U before belongs to U, and I consider the dynamics X equal X0 Q, okay? Because X0 is the number, and Q is here. And I can write the system X0 dot equals pi of Q U, and Q dot equals F U of Q, and all together it can be written as X dot equal F U of Q. So new system in the little bit greater manifold. And if I resolve this system, then solution X of T, X of T is just. So how to resolve? So this guy does not depend on X. First, you resolve this. If you plug in here control, now plug in here control, we get trajectory as a solution of the system. We also consider X of zero as initial condition. X initial condition, we take zero and Q zero, okay? So the original system was in the manifold term. That is, any manifold term is a plane. And this is an extra coordinate. So this is point Q zero. And extra coordinate start in the zero. To resolve this system, we resolve this one, get a trajectory, and then plug in trajectory here. Control is here and integrate, because here is just integral, okay? So we obtain JT of U. If Q0 is fixed, it depends only on U, JT of U. And here we obtain Q of T U of T dot, okay? So that is what is the solution. And absolutely obvious fact that is as follows. Then we consider attainable set for time t for this system, for the extended system, we consider attainable set A x of zero of t. That is a set of all x of t, u of dot, like that. That is a set of all x of t, u of dot, for all L infinite controls. So, and I claim is absolutely obvious, claim if U is optimal, if this cost attains minimum at control U, U tilde is optimal, then X dt for fixed time, say, optimal for the problem with fixed time t1, then xt1 belongs to the border of A x of 0 of t1, okay? So that is totally trivial. Look, and it is main properties, so not all boundary belongs to the optimal, but it's somehow if we modify costs to then. But the main question is to characterize those which arrive to bound. Geometrically, what I would like to say, geometrically to be optimal means to stay on the boundary of attainable set of certain dynamical system, certain control system related, cooked from our original and the cost. It is always like that. This is the main meaning of optimality, okay? Why it is like that? Why it is like that? but it should be clear. Let me draw again this picture of M and R. And let us draw attainable set. It's, here we have a Q0, here we have Q1, we start here. And okay, so our trajectory of original system arrived to Q1, if and only if the trajectory of extended system arrive to this line, okay? All coordinates, but first one is Q1, trajectory belongs to A1. So let us consider our attainable set. It is some set, we start here, then we arrive somewhere. It is some set here, attainable set, AT1. We assume that we can come to Q1 with some with different cost of x of zero. And so you see, so we are in Q1 if and only if for extended system we are on this line. And we are optimal if and only if it is we arrive in the lowest point on the attainable set. So this is automatically in the border. Of course, not all board. Also, maximum of the border is on the border. There are other parts of the border. But main point, what is the problem? There is a huge number of trajectories which arrive controls, which give you point here. Such that we can move. We can, any control, we can move. And the principal property is if we are interested in optimal control, we are interested only on those. We have to characterize them, first of all. And this way we characterize attainable set because we know both the dynamics of attainable set and minimize any kind of cost. So this is the main message. So, you know, I started from problem which comes from Q0, Q1, but now I reformulated it as a problem which should give you all possible solutions for all possible Q1. If you are in the, if you, for all Q1, for any Q1, it's as in calculus of regression is always like that, and in constraint optimization. Instead of study system with precise conditions, we consider family and characterize all possible solutions for all family. Somehow you divide your problem in two parts. First, from huge, infinite dimensional, terrible number of admissible controls, you select those. Quite a restrictive family which can be optimal. And then working with this, which can be optimal, those which are extremal somehow, which go to which lead to the boundary. And then among this, and this is already finite dimensional, quite restrictive family, extreme control, you solve boundary value problem. Try to characterize those of them, the two different kinds of problems. Those of them which connect points you wish. And also the main natural application of control theory, also in engineering, there are a lot of applications. Control theory was grown from engineering. First, it was engineering subject, then it was developed a purely mathematical subject, which can be applied to other parts of pure mathematics. But again, the basic idea is like that. If you have some dynamics and cost also, cost can be incorporated in dynamics, then at the beginning, you are interested only in the dynamics and cost, not on the boundary condition. And looking at this, studying those guys who arrive to the boundary of attainable set, you give rules of optimal behavior independently of boundary condition. For applications, you can very naturally formulate it. So if you want to be optimal, you have to take your control is very particular family. Family depends on the dynamic only. And then in this particular family, you can visit you. So main idea of mathematical theory, engineers, of course, they have their condition, they have to solve this. But it is essentially remains for them with their tools. But mathematical question is to give these rules of optimal behavior independently on the boundary condition, okay? And we have corresponding tools. But first, what we have to discuss here. This is one more remark, maybe, how to reduce. So what I say concerns fixed time problem. But actually, free time problem can be very easily reduced to the fixed time. Again, when you take reduction, so one problem, here we added to reduce optimal control, to reduce the problem of minimizing integral cost to the characterization of the boundary, we added one variable in the state space M. If you would like to reduce problem with free time to the fixed time, we add one control parameter. And it is just two examples of simple manipulations and reduce one problem to another. What control parameter we use? Because the advantage of this setting is it is quite general. Since you have any dynamics, any dependence on you, you may put here a lot of different problems in one setting, okay? How do you reduce free time to fixed time? That very, very simple. X dot equals fu of x of t. You consider such a system. And then if you rescale, you simply rescale time. You simply change time. You take time rescaling. And you consider some time substitution of time. Phi, not phi, it already being A, which stands monotonic function R to R. A dot, call it, say, V, non-negative, and consider problem like this. So you go along the same trajectories, more or less, because U is any, you can always, the same trajectories with different velocities, okay? It's one more freedom. If you have two time, you have free time, it means that you don't have other trajectories, but you can change velocity you have. So you write system like that. X dot equals V fu of x, and now your control is vu, v scala belongs to r plus multiplied by u, okay? And we have a problem, and now we can take fixed time. Rescale time, we can always choose fixed, okay? Rescale. So, and this is just two examples, but there are many other formulations that all. And each time you reduce essentially the problem to characterizing to a geometric problem of characterizing guys which go to the boundary. Okay, so and let us try to understand how to solve this problem, how to characterize this extremal control that is the most fast or most slow that goes to the boundary, leads to the boundary. And first of all, of course, we have enough of them to characterize the boundary and to solve optimal control problem only if boundary is really attained, only if attainable set is closed, okay? So we have to, if attainable set is closed, so you see we have, then the minimum exists. Minimum, if not, unlikely. Of course, you can go deeper, say which kind of the boundary is here, which is not, but at least for the purpose of the course, these details are not important at all. We would like to discuss principles. okay, when we can guarantee that the guy is closed, there is a first of all, it's not a good idea, bad idea to assume that U is compact, of course, that controller really bound. It seems to be very restrictive because it's a classical variational problem. U is not compact. U is free, simply. And still we often have we have regular variational problem with existence theorem. But if you think about this, this is a one more. So we assume now that U is compact. For existence, as I already mentioned, we need more than for the equation which characterizes optimal control. If there exists optimal control, is determined by some equation, it satisfies some, we see, Pantryagin maximum principle, even if U is any set, but we don't know if it exists. If it exists, it must satisfy these conditions. But to be existent, but U compact is certainly, first of all, how we reduce very briefly variational problem to this case. One more reduction. I don't explain otherwise I don't go far, but just to give a hint how in principle you can do it. You know, in the variation, in calculus of variation, to guarantee the existence, you need that the Lagrangian grows fast enough when you go to infinity, okay? It grows fast enough when you go to infinity. And otherwise, you do not have existence. But if it's Lagrangian, but then what is the idea? What is the idea? You take your cost, you take your cost as a new time. Your cost as a new time. So you start from the problem, say, Q dot equals U in calculus of variation, but you can generalize it at maybe some dynamics. That U can be free and dynamics should grow, FU should grow less than, not so fast as a cost and divide it in phi of QU. Because as a new, we take new times, if we take new times say S, is integral of 0 dt phi of qu, dt then dq over ds rescaling is going to be like that, okay? It's going to be like that. Mm-hmm. And this, if this guy has superlinear growth when you go to infinity, then the right hand side go to 0 when you go to infinity. And superlinear growth is a natural conjecture with total guarantee existence. And then you can simply compactify u. Instead of your u was here is some Rn, and you simply compactify it at infinity and get a compact guy as Sn. And your system is well defined. If you see on the conditions which people put for existence, they exactly condition that guarantee you that it's still at least Lipschitzian, but Lipschitzian is sufficient for us to have a well posed Cauchy problem. Including infinity when you compactify it, okay? You take u belongs to here. This one more reduction, and you appear in the setting VR with a compact u. It's also possible, but compact u is not sufficient. That is very clear. It should be clear also from the previous lecture. It should be clear from the previous lecture why it's not sufficient. Because you know that if attainable, because what does it mean compact u? It could be just 2 points, for example. 2 points are compact. We have one dynamics, another dynamics, fu1, fu2. And as I explained last lecture, we can approximate, and if you consider the system Q dot, say alpha fu1 of Q plus minus, or I can write even V to see that's closer to controls, 1 over V fu of Q of T, then we can always treating V as a one more control, we can always approximate. We go like that, like that, like that, like that, like that. and we can always approximate it by admissible trajectory. But but the trajectory itself is not admissible, this trajectory satisfies where V smaller than one. I take convexification. Any trajectory whose velocity belongs to convexification can be uniformly approximated by admissible, but it is not admissible. And of course, for simplest possible problems with constant vector fields, if vector fields are constant, so these guys are indeed broken lines. In particular, if it is piecewise constant, and what we are minimizing is length, then, of course, minimal is straight line, and it is not admissible, okay? But if you convexify, we have it. So absolutely, if you would like to have general result, absolutely unavoidably to and moreover, it is very natural that instead of fu, to take a convexification of fu. And convexification may be realized again by adding, if you want, by adding extra parameters, okay? Because if we have a set in Rn here in the tangent space to n-dimensional manifold, then any point in the convexification can be obtained as a convex combination of no more than n plus one points, so you add in extra this coefficients of convexification of linear combination, adding new controls, you take your system with a convex. And convexification is the first step to do, because indeed it is like to go from rational number to real numbers. We can approximate any way, we can uniformly approximate any trajectory with convexified velocities. And it's when we would like to have something really closed, it's like approximate a rational real number by rational. You take a sequence and the new point, okay? So by something closed, that it is the first step to do. So it's not like, it's not restrictive condition. It's nature of your problem. You have a hidden convexity here. If you need, you have a chance to have existence if you are convex, and if you are not convex, maybe you are not have existence, but anyway, you can approximate arbitrarily well your, the dot optimal solution that you obtain from the convex problem. So main conditions are now the theorem is a Filippov theorem, but what I would like to say is it's Filippov theorem, rather simple, by the way. No, it should be, yes, since it's in Russia, it is Filippov. And from in 60s, proved even in 60s, that contain, if you think about that, use some reduction, all the basic existence theorems in calculus of variation. It says the following, if we have a dynamic Q dot equals Fu of Q, U belongs to U, this is compact, and Fu of Q is convex. If your manifold is not compact, you need some this I perhaps omit, some growth condition of F simply to guarantee that solution do not blow up. I just say that we add, in particular, if it guy should be, if this guy grows in Rn, this guy should grow not faster than linear functions when Q goes to infinity. Or it's not necessary Rn if you are in the, you can formulate it also if M is a complete, you need some estimate on infinity. In principle, you know, if your system does not depend on U, just you have dynamics, it is not I did not discuss it, but because not to just to economy time, some time. But in fact, the flow, if you have a vector field, in general, you do not have flow if you are not on the compact manifold, because trajectory is defined only for small time and may blow up. So we always assume some estimate that they do not blow up, that if you take a control from U, that's easy to write, but it's not related very much to what we are studying. And so if we use just controls from compact set, from this compact set, and go limited time, then we stay in the compact. We start from Q0, take a control from compact set. That assumption we always mean. Or we may simply assume that the manifold is compact. That is also not a so terrible assumption, because this compact can be extremely big. Okay, if you're interested in only what happens in some bond domain, you do not care what is about, what dynamic is about. As soon as your trajectory, you can even, also you can multiply your right-hand side by some cutoff function, because you are not, and then everything will be fine. No growth at all out of compact. Because you're interested only in trajectories that stay in some compact that go out, you do not care, okay? It's essentially, our theory is about that. Because of that, I do not discuss much this completeness of right-hand side properties. Okay, so convex and some conditions, some growth condition on F, completeness plus complete, this is compact, this is, and also Fu of T are complete vector fields. In Rn, complete vector field. In Rn, for this is sufficient that Fu of Q is smaller than C1 plus Q. Okay? Growth linearly, say. That's everyone should know. In particular, this is one of the condition. And it's analog in the complete Riemannian manifold is also easy to write. Okay, so the theorem says that in this case, then AT AQ0 of T is closed, is compact, it's simply compact. Compact. It's bounded because we assume that blow up is not possible, and it's closed. It's the main statement is closed. That is not, it's rather simple. I do not want to, because already one half of my, almost one half of my lecture passed, and I do not want to discuss a lot. But maybe I say something. I say something. How you prove it? First of all, since you consider admissible trajectories, actually, we prove even more, not only attainable set. For us, it's most important that attainable set is compact. For the existence, it's important for us. But in fact, also the set of admissible trajectories on given segment are closed and compact in C0 topology. Okay? In C0 topology. First of all, since we assume that velocities are bounded, we do not have blow. The trajectories are uniformly bounded if you consider fu of t, of q of t. Since trajectories are uniformly bounded, right-hand side is continuous, then we, the starting from point q0, then we see that since velocity is bounded, all trajectories are Lipschitzian with the same Lipschitz constant. So it is, here we do not need convexity of the right-hand side. They're all Lipschitzian with the same Lipschitz constant. So they are compact, pre-compact in the C0 topology, okay? So for Arscoli-Arcella theorem, there exists, if you have a U1 of dot, some sequence of now what we would like to show that attainable set is closed, okay? So we have a sequence of trajectories such that endpoint converge. You have this guy, it's Q of un of dot, okay? Q of un, say, I omit this dot, at un, and we know that Q of t1 un converge to some point q hat, say, okay? We would like to show that, to find control to show that there exists U hat such that, then this is a question, there exists U hat such that Q is Q of T1. Okay, how to do it? We cannot guarantee, that's a problem. What, for the moment, I never used the convexity of right-hand side. We can guarantee that there exists a limiting subsequence of trajectories. So we can go to this subsequence. We may assume that Q of T un uniformly converge to some trajectory, to some Q of, to some, say, gamma T, with the same Lipschitz constant, okay? That's all this we know from Arcoli-Arcella theory. But this, of course, we do not converge. Velocities in this theorem, the trajectory is uniformly converged, but the velocities do not converge. We do not, and moreover, un do not converge in general. But the trick is, and at this point we have to, and indeed in general, since velocities do not converge, that in general this trajectory is not admissible. But if you think about that, you see that convexity save the us, and if right hand side is convex, then we find another control, not limit of this one, but another control. Then at least velocity of limiting line will be in the always in the convexification of this. That's what we have to prove. Without details, it follows from so we have a limiting guy, which is Lipschitz, it's differentiable everywhere. And what remains is to find the velocity of this limiting curve and to show that it belongs to the convexification of velocities of admissible velocities. That's rather simple because we take this gamma of t plus epsilon, it takes first we take Qn at t plus epsilon minus Qn of t. We remember what does it mean velocity, okay? And you know that this satisfies our differential equation. So we rewrite it as integral equation. It will be 1 over epsilon from t tilde t plus epsilon f un of dot of qn of dot of t of tau d tau, okay? Of tau d tau. So this is just because there are solutions to that before limit, there are solutions to our differential equation, okay? And look, this guy converges. Moreover, this is uniformly converged to gamma. So we, in this way, we obtain this difference when we go to limit here. And here, this is not. But we take anyway 1 over epsilon and integral. It's average of this guy. It is average. So it belongs to convexification. And in the limit, we obtain that gamma of t plus epsilon minus gamma of t divided over epsilon automatically belongs, because each time it belongs to convexification. And this converges to gamma, or this convexification are compact, so everything converges uniformly. And it's belongs to 1 over epsilon t plus epsilon. And here we have a conv fu of gamma, okay? Of tau d tau. For small epsilon, again, gamma then we send epsilon to zero, this goes to the derivative of gamma, and here we get just some element of convexification of fu at point gamma of t. Okay. Because here we have a union of convexification. Oh, better to write here, not like that, it is maybe more clear. To be sure, a little bit bigger space t, tau t smaller than tau smaller than t plus epsilon, fu of gamma of tau, okay? So this is for sure, because all of them belong to it, okay? So this difference for sure stay, because when we take integrals, we do not leave this space. And then when the epsilon tau, so you see that velocity belongs to convexification. There is still the boring detail velocity belongs so if velocity belongs to convexification and we assume that the set of admissible velocities is convex, then for any, so we can find some u such that gamma dot is f of from the convexification, from the convexity condition, we get that gamma dot f gamma dot of t is f of some u bar of t of gamma of t that we obtained. Still there is some boring details. It needs some effort to show that this u can be selected measurable. It's not automatic, but it can be done. It can be done. U always can be selected measurable because controlled must be, it's not some function on t, but it is still measurable, okay? But it also can be done, no problem. That's it, that's all. So if we are convinced, so natural condition that, which I add immediately, no, the natural conditions for existence, I don't know, for existence, this is the natural conditions are that u is compact and the velocity are convex. But for, now I would like try to characterize, control which go to the boundary. I can do it now quietly, but now I know that there are natural conditions when they exist, but when I characterize it, I do not care. I just assume, let this guy goes to the boundary and try to see which condition it satisfies. And what conditions are called Pontryagin maximum principle. Again, I do not give many details, but but try to explain actually what is going on. Maybe I even formulate maybe first some hints and then I formulate before I even formulating the problem I do. So the geometric picture, because geometric picture is important here. So we have Q0, we have attainable set, we have trajectory which goes to the boundary of attainable set, okay? AQ0 of T. And trajectory goes to the boundary, okay? First thing to do is, then for the moment, what I do now, it's totally heuristic because in the Pontryagin maximum principle appears some extra parameters which for, at the first glance can be look quite artificial. And first I just explain the meaning of this parameter without rigorous mathematics, what means essentially this parameter. And then I formulate the result when you already understand that parameter somehow natural. And then I try to explain, I believe that I will have time, why it is correct, how to prove it. So assume that everything is perfect, absolutely perfect, this guy is a smooth. In fact, that's attainable set maybe quite complicated. But to explain meaning of this extra parameter, assume that it is absolutely perfect. It is a smooth manifold with a border, okay? And then if it is smooth manifold with a border, then there are a tangent plane, tangent hyper, full dimensional. If it is not full dimensional, by the way, that our condition are going to be empty because it's not full dimensional, that then any control lead to the any point is in the boundary, okay? But we know, we already studied this question. We have natural condition when things are full dimensional. This we already know. So we assume that it is full dimensional, otherwise for us it's too degenerate problem. And actually, normally it means unfortunately in these four lectures I cannot explain everything, but if that full dimension guaranteed by bracket generating condition, okay? But if we do not have bracket generating condition, it means essentially that we have some variables such that your problem simply does not depend on this variable. So you may reduce it to reduce if Lie algebra, this algebraic object, is has low dimensional, then we can reduce our problem to the lower submanifold where it is full dimensional. It means that essentially means that all M is sliced by submanifold. We have some foliation such that attainable set belong to the leaf of the foliation. And then we simply reduce things to this leaf. There is also this part of the theory. So again, like convexification, bracket generation condition is somehow is not really restriction. It simply gives you that your problem depends on all variables. Otherwise, you exclude those it does not depend on. So fine. So, but assume that it is a body like that, and then there is the normal. There is a hyperplane assume that this is velocity of our trajectory, it's our trajectory, it's velocity gamma dot. And it looks like that. So we arrive as far, on the boundary, and there is a normal. And this, in order to characterize those which go to the boundary, it is actually most natural to characterize these covectors, which we can also normalize. So we consider, let us, lambda is a, belongs to T star of gamma of T M. It's a linear form. Lambda is a linear form T gamma of T M to R, linear form on the tangent space, And such that it annihilates the boundary, the tangent space to the boundary. And we can also normalize it in such a way, say that lambda gamma of T dot is a constant, okay? Is a constant. Is sim 1, say 1. Say one. Now look. Since we deal with evolutionary problem, that if gamma of T, I claim that if gamma of T belongs to the A, to the boundary of A Q0 of T, then gamma of S belongs to the boundary of AQ0 of S for any S smaller than T. For any S smaller than T. Why it is like that? Why it is like that? It is also very easy to see. Here it is like that because of the fact which we always use in the controllability, in the study of controllability, because if you have a admissible trajectory, it's ruled by some control, and this control gives us the whole flow, not one trajectory, but the whole flow. Look, assume on the contrary, I would like to explain this property. Assume that on the contrary, there is some S that gamma of S belongs to the interior of A Q0 of S. Okay? And this gamma dot is f u of satisfy this condition is a solution of this ODE. it's particularly just we studied the now one trajectory, but it's give you if we call it in U gamma, it maybe we can call it U gamma. If you have admissible trajectory, you have some control. But with this control, now consider the flow p to t that send any q of tau in the q of t in virtue, or say, for us it could be s, maybe beta, in virtue of the equation q dot equals f u gamma of t q. Okay? So what we do now? To obtain attainable set, we fixed initial position and apply all possible controls. But now, since we have one particular control, we fix this control and apply it to all possible initial conditions. Okay? We always play this game. This game also in controllability theory, we did like that. So this is just a diffeomorphism. P to T is invertible diffeomorphism, MM. And moreover, P to T minus 1. Minus 1 is just P. Because here, S, it's defined also not necessary when T is bigger than S. It's equal. When you just take a fixed ODE, time varying ODE, you can go back, forward, whatever you want. So it's invertible if T is. It's invertible. You can go back and forward. You have a unique solution. And then what you do? Assume that you are in the, now take your Q0, your attainable set, a lot of trajectories that cover, that is our gamma, and this is AQ0 of S, okay? AQ0 of S. And it happens that we are inside. We are inside. This is gamma of S, gamma of S. Then what we can do? I claim that if we apply P, S, T, and trajectories of P, S, T are all admissible because all of them moreover correspond to the same control gamma. If we apply P, S of T to A, Q0 of S, then it is obviously contained in the A, AAQ0 of T. What we do here? We use all possible controls until the moment S. Until the moment S, we use all possible control to get our attainable set. And then apply special control, just this is, will be U gamma. This is Q of U gamma of T U gamma. So, and then apply the flow. So we take this set at moment S and apply flow. But flow is a diffeomorphism. It's sent. So what we obtain is will be subset of this guy. Those which obtained with very particular control. So before S it was arbitrary control and then just fixed. And since diffeomorphism is invertible, so if we were in the interior here, we will be in the interior here. So if we at the end point in the border, we were in the border all the time. And you do not need, it is almost set theory. All you need is correctness of Cauchy problem. You do not need special estimates and things like that. So it's a absolutely universal property due to evolutionary nature of our, it's just evolutionary nature of our problem, just to see why this property are going on. So when we go ahead, we have more and more possibilities, new and new possibilities appear. All we reached is somehow we already, more and more controls. Set of controls, control function on segment S can be treated as a subset of a control function on segment T, okay? So our possibilities are increasing. It does not mean, of course, that attainable set is increasing, because it may happen that it is moving for all f. But okay, but it's increasing in this sense which I explained. okay, so that's what I would like to. And now, we know that for any S, we have a lambda of S. This we call lambda, I'm sorry, this we call lambda T. And for any S smaller than T, we define lambda S. That in the same way, this is AS. That is a normal, since we always on the boundary, on the border, we may define lambda at S, then such that this is Q0 of S, such that this is gamma of S, this is a point gamma of S, such that it is a normal vector to covector to the attainable, to the boundary of attainable set. Again, of course, what I write here, it's only if boundary is fine. But the general result, we will not depend on these details. The point is, the message is that this lambda, so we have a lambda of S, lambda S, which belong to T star gamma of Sm. We have this attainable set moving, and but we always on the boundary, so there is a covector which annihilates boundary in the nice case. If attainable set is nice, it is like that. So we have a lift of our trajectory to cotangent bundle, and conditions characterize this lift. Maybe those who remember Huygens' principle, it's essentially in the wave propagation, is essentially version of the universal Huygens' principle. So principle, it's natural to characterize such a, in mechanics it would be momentum, this covector would be momentum in mechanics, because mechanics is also ruled by the variational principles, but at least action principle, but it is has so general nature for optimal, it can be defined for optimal control problem in extremely general setting without this condition on the smoothness of the boundary and so on. So we have for any good trajectory, extremal trajectory, there exist such a lambda S, which is such a lift, so I would like to draw a picture. So this is going to be M, this is T star, if this is Q0, this is T star Q0, M, and this is all T star M. So we have our trajectory here. Unfortunately, since cotangent bundle is even dimensional, it's hard to draw pictures, so you can draw it only, four-dimensional picture you can draw, and I need to use one-dimensional M. That is not a good idea because no many trajectories one-dimensional, but you can imagine that it is n-dimensional, this is n-dimensional. So we have our trajectories, gamma of S, smaller than T, and we have, over it, we have, this is fibers are cotangent spaces, we have this lambda S, this is gamma S, that lambda S is a lift. We have a lift in the cotangent bundle of lambda S, and the message is that this lift survive well all possible degenerate situation. And now I formulate the main result, Pontryagin maximum principle, and this is a good characterization of Pondragon maximum principle for this geometric version of optimal control problem. Then we just characterize the trajectories which lead go to the boundary of attainable set. So theorem. So this Huygens principle can be applied to very general situation. So it is Pondragon maximum principle. So PMP, Pondragon maximum principle. So write the following. I even rewrite this is FU of Q. This is our Hamiltonian system. I'm sorry, this control system, but very soon will appear also Hamiltonian system. And then we write the following function on cotangent bundle, elementary function. We simply lift this vector fields to cotangent cotangent bundle. So we write Hamiltonian of your system is HU of PQ. This is just P FU of Q, nothing else. And as we know, I do it in coordinates, but you perhaps know that if you have a cotangent bundle to any function, you can associate a Hamiltonian vector field. Then the theorem PFP. If this is notation, and now the theorem. If Q of dot belongs to the boundary of the attainable set, then there exists a solution, normal Lipschitz solution, of the Hamiltonian system . Then there exists lambda S that is lift belongs to the T star of gamma. That's what I told gamma S of M. Lift to cotangent bundle of, and the meaning of this lambda you already know, such that, but now it is a theorem, it is, we don't need extra condition. Our conditions are only I recall that we have a continuity with respect to U of the right-hand side, smoothness with respect to Q, how many derivatives you see, but you see not too much, I think. Lipschitz, so it's, I don't care. And U is any subset of some submanifold. Of some finite dimension, any, not necessarily closed, compact, nothing. But if it is not closed, if you do not have convexity, that we do not reach all points of the boundary. But if by chance we reached one by some trajectory, it must satisfy this condition. That's the point. And now conditions, so such that this lambda is, now look, this lambda, actually, let us write, because I would like to write in coordinates, do not introduce all intrinsic notations. So we can, it's good idea to think about lambda as an element, as a point in the cotangent bundle, because we would like now to write a dynamical system in the cotangent bundle. But actually, in coordinates, you can split it. This lambda S is PS gamma of S, okay? So if we have coordinates, so we have a point here. And we have a point on the fiber, momentum. Then there exists lambda s, that is a p s gamma of s, is a pair, such that it satisfies Hamiltonian system. So p dot equals minus dhu over dq, and gamma dot is dh over dp. U of s, if our time is now s and t is just the last time, last moment, of ps gamma of s, and this is dh over dp of ps gamma of s, okay? So we have it satisfies such a Hamiltonian system. So for the moment, it is just nothing. Of course, we have any control, trajectory, we can write Hamiltonian system, and any solution of this Hamiltonian system satisfies it. We need a condition which eliminates U. This is not one Hamiltonian system, but Hamiltonian system depends on the arbitrary function U of S. We need a condition to, and this is a, and now it's right. So it satisfies this Hamiltonian system. And also the we have this Hamiltonian. Let us introduce one more Hamiltonian. Sometimes people call it master Hamiltonian, just H, which depends only on PQ. Only on PQ. I'm sorry, so here lambda is PQ. Lambda is PQ. You always think in two ways. You may, because intrinsically you cannot separate, without coordinates separate P of Q, but lambda is defined also intrinsically. Covector is defined intrinsically. I'm sorry. This Hamiltonian H of PQ is defined like this. So you take P and apply it to F of U, but P is actually U of Q. But it can be also written intrinsically and covector lambda applied to tangent vector of U of Q. Covector lambda belongs to the cotangent space to Q. Okay. So this is a space of the lambda and of lambda, and if you consider it's the lambda, H lambda knows it's Q because it's the cotangent bundle is a fiber bundle. We take any point. It belongs to some fiber, and this fiber is Q. Intrinsically, it's like that. You do not separate. You have fibers, but you do not have horizontal guys. Horizontal guys appear only in coordinates, okay? So lambda is PQ, this is like that. So this can be written also in more intrinsic ways, lambda dot equals H U of S of lambda s, where h v zero is a Hamiltonian vector field associated to this Hamiltonian function h. This system can be written like that. And now condition which allow us to eliminate U. So condition is like that H U of S of PS gamma of S. Actually, if you want it, it's lambda S, just this pair, is equals to the maximum. Sorry, what is written here? HU, no. HU is like that. I'm sorry, I did not write it. H of PQ is the maximum maximum for all u of h u of pq. Master Hamiltonian is the maximum. The maximum. So here we have a family which depends on the parameter u. To eliminate this family, we take a maximum. So the condition is that this if we are extremal, if our trajectory goes to the control, corresponding trajectory goes to the boundary of attainable set, then there exists solution of this Hamiltonian system such that along this solution, our Hamiltonian attains its maximum with respect to u. Always maximum with respect to u. So this is something that is always true, always valid. And in so general situation. Now I give an exercise, simple exercise. Of course, in our setting, this maximum is something non-smooth. Certainly non-smooth, it may be non-smooth function, but in particular, if our u, if u is a segment, in particular, let us start with most simple problem when we have just two dynamics. First step is to convexify them. This is a point q, this is f u1 of q. This is fu2 of q. So we may always assume that minimal possible situation and when dynamics is a segment. If we take now maximum, and what you would like to, what is written here is maximum, you take some covector p, some linear form. You simply maximize linear form p. Say psi, in this situation h of p, this velocity is at point q, and point q is a maximum of p psi, where psi belongs to our segment. We take maximum with respect to all admissible velocities. Psi, where psi belongs to this segment, say delta, belongs to delta, okay? Clearly, it's continuous, of course, but of course, it is not smooth, because when your p is transversal to the segment, that it is just a linear function. Because the maximum is attained on one at the same, the maximum is attained on one at the same p. But when it becomes, but then you switch. And your function is not differentiable. Because your jump, when velocity jump from one, if p is like that, then a maximum is attained here. If p is like that, maximum, the linear form is constant on delta. But then it switched to other. But if p is like that, then it switched here. So you have a kind of con. Derivative is jumps. Okay, so in general, it is like that. In many interesting situations, it is like that. Somehow it is like that always, and that for us is most interesting. Situation when set of admissible velocities has a smaller, it's some convex set, if it has a smaller dimension, but most interesting for us it's when it has rather big codimension. If it's smaller dimension than Abelian space, then you do not have smoothness. You always jump, because for some p are going to be orthogonal to this attainable, to this set of admissible velocities, and when I pass P, which is orthogonal, you always jump. You have discontinuity of various kinds. So for optimal control problems, we have to deal with this situation. But this guy is always, this is always true anyway. These conditions are always true anyway. And if we are lucky, if we, particularly in regular variational problems, we are indeed lucky, and this maximum is smooth. If attainable, if set of admissible velocity is a strictly convex body, then maximum is priest. For full dimensions, then maximum is smooth. Then maximum is smooth, and assume that this is smooth. Exercise. If C2, if H of PS, of PQ, is a C2 function, is C2, then the pair P of S, gamma of S, satisfies PMP, satisfies PMP, if and only if it is a, it already shows essentially what this condition. If and only if it satisfies Hamiltonian system with H. No control here. In this situation, we can first eliminate control, simply maximizing Hamiltonian, and then write Hamiltonian system, and all solutions are here. Gamma dot equals dH over dP of P gamma. So this is a simple situation. This is our optimal law for good behavior, for optimal, for good behavior, very clear recipe. We maximize. We write Hamiltonian, which depends on u, eliminate u, simply maximizing the scalar product, and all solutions are here. So it looks like that. It looks like that. And so somehow P, instead of control, now we have P, but P is well controlled. We have this momentum P, but P is well controlled. So, and somehow this, if you count parameters, it is the maximum we can do. In such a general, it's maximum we can do. Indeed, look, in our cotangent bundle, so this is now M, you assume that this guy has the same dimension, T star M. Fibers have the same dimension. We have some point Q0, and we have attainable set at any point. This is full dimensional. At any point of attainable set, we have some trajectory. Okay? And if the trajectory goes to the boundary, it means that they exist. But when H is H capital, master Hamiltonian is smooth, it means that the derivative is fine, is Lipschitz. If it is C2, it is even C1, the derivative is even C1, that this is determines a flow. If we have Q0 and also P0, then you have a well-defined trajectory, unique well-defined trajectory of P0, okay? And this P0, we have n-dimensional family of trajectories starting from Q0. But in fact, if you think about it a little bit, that since Hamiltonian is homogeneous, then Hamiltonian is homogeneous because this is homogeneous with respect to P. This is even linear. Linear with respect to P. If you maximize linear function, you obtain some con. By the way, it is con, always con, automatically convex as a function of P, but it's not homogeneous. Just some convex function, smooth, non-smooth. You see that if we have a set of admissible velocity low dimension, that is never smooth. But in full dimension, it is smooth. Okay, so So my time is over. I'm just finishing few words to say. So since it is homogeneous, then rescaling of P does not change. If you rescale P, you rescale homogeneous of degree one. You just rescale the whole trajectory, okay? Multiplying P0 by constant, you simply multiply the trajectory you obtain. It's simply multiplication of your original trajectory by the same constant. So the Q is, so in fact, the Q of T depends only on projectivization of up to multiplier is determined by P up to scalar multiplier. Okay, so we have in fact really we have only n minus one dimensional set of admissible parameters of initial conditions, and we have n minus one dimensional board of attainable set, and due to existence theorem to any if you are convex of course now assume that we If we are not convex at the very beginning, that Hamiltonian again not smooth, because when we take convexification, we have some flat pieces, and Hamiltonian not smooth. Some P can be orthogonal to the whole phase. So, but if we are convex, then we know that there is optimal trajectories going to any point on the boundary, attainable set is closed. And we have n minus one, we need n minus one dimensional family of trajectories to cover the board, that to characterize attainable set, to characterize optimal guys. So, and we have this theorem give us already n minus one dimensional family, so minimal possible, the law of optimal behavior. Okay, so that's in the smooth case. But the main point, the advantage of this result, why it is more powerful and more interesting than classical things when you also can find is rational mechanics and calculus of variation, then I many times thought that it as it formulated, it works even if maximum is not smooth. If maximum is not smooth, this is not defined and not so clear how to interpret solutions. And not even if it, you can invent a way to interpret solutions somehow right-hand side is discontinuous, of discontinuous right-hand sign, but not at all solutions are interesting for optimization problems. But this result always true. So the good idea it was not to eliminate U from the very beginning, but first write ODE where U is presented, and additional, so the whole system to study, and essentially when you study it even, here everything is well defined. Because here we have a smooth right-hand side. It's not smooth only with respect to T, but that for us is not a problem that we always can do. It's well-posed Cauchy problem. And the whole system of condition is such a differential equation, Hamiltonian system, and identity and point-wise identity. So this is valid for all s from 0 to t. So you should first write ODE and then use this condition to eliminate. So, and of course, there is a well-developed theory how to do it, how to characterize different kinds of trajectories which satisfy it, that also can be branch somehow. But in principle, it can be. It can, a normal situation is just to finish, so unfortunately I do not have time to explain the proof. The complete proof is a bit technical. I have an idea to have a simple explanation, but perhaps I need one more lecture. And for that. But at least I showed the meaning of this covectors I showed. So in general, so of course this guy is not smooth, but we consider first order approximations of attainable set locally, within local first order approximations. And first order approximation due to hidden convexity, which you perhaps already understand, is a kind of convex cone. And we take this covector that is defines the plane of support for this convex cone, okay? That's what we do. And if convex cone is full dimensional, then also, because it's first approximation, it's full dimensional, higher order terms do not destroy. If it's full dimensional, then in first approximation, you are inside, you cover the whole neighborhood, and the higher order terms do not destroy this fact. It's some elaboration of not exactly implicit function theorem, but technically not much more complicated, okay, than implicit function theorem. So you characterize it just a normal covector to first order approximation. And it's important the first order approximation is convex for any problem because of that hidden convex, because of the relaxation of hidden convex. Essentially, that's how it works. And when you apply it, the situation is like that. So I already draw this picture with a segment, or it could be something more complicated of lower dimension. So in fact, of course, your maximum is not smooth. But it is convex, it's smooth with respect to Q and convex with respect to P. And it is smooth on some domains, on some subdomains in smooth, and then you have corners, angles, and things like that. So you have an object to study. In fact, the situation in the domains when it is smooth, you are ruled, you are governed by such a Hamiltonian system. You have different smooth Hamiltonian flow that links in non-smooth surfaces of non-smoothness. And what you have to study, and this is sufficient material to understand many things, what you have to study, how good trajectories which satisfied globally for all team Pontryagin maximum principle must be glued in this surfaces of non-smoothness. Some of them belong to the surfaces of non-smoothness. For the most interesting, maybe, just go along the non-smoothness surfaces, then but they also can be studied. So this is essentially what you do in optimal control. Okay, thank you for attention. I finish my presentation.